how is this year different to last year?
It is a very similar year, as you said, and I think that I'm positively surprised it has been as robust as it's been. It's going to be another year where we're going to be challenging to get to that 4 trillion mark that we saw in 07 and 2015. And, you know, right now we're running about 5% below last year. So really another very strong, you know, good year for M&A.
Is it different regions to 2018? And is it different sectors?
Well, what has defined this year has been transforming activity in North America. I look at deals that have value greater than $10 billion and defining transforming deals. There's been 45 such deals this year. 35 of those have involved U.S. corporations. The U.S. has accounted for 60% of volumes in 2019. So that has been the feature of the market. And I think that it's also a wake-up call for the rest of the world, and particularly for Europe, because if this trend continues, where U.S. companies do 50, $100 billion deals, continue doubling in size, if this trend were to persist, at some point in time, European corporations, maybe Japanese corporations, are going to start losing their competitive edge. So I do think that, also looking forward to 2020, what I hope and I expect is more activity from outside of the U.S.
But Hernan, so people buy other companies for a number of reasons, right? It's either because they feel weak, they want critical mass, because they want higher margins, because they see the one jewel in the crown that they don't have. Mm-hmm. Are people actually consolidating for the right reason?
I think this market is very logical. It makes sense for pharma companies to hedge their R&D bets by acquiring companies that have late product R&D. It makes sense for there to be auto consolidation. It makes sense for consolidation online brokers. It makes sense for payments to become global in scale. The year has been very logical in terms of decision making for M&A.
But
also a discipline. It's also a disciplined market because we've seen a lot of separation activity, logical carve outs where companies, you know, want to focus on the core competences. Where it's Dow DuPont, G separating healthcare to with Danaher, Novartis separating Alcon. It's also a logical and a disciplined market.
But
so the quality of the market is very good.
But is it because they're under pressure? So, for example, the car industry, do they need to consolidate? Because if you don't consolidate, then you go out of business.
You have to evolve. You have to keep moving forward. You cannot stay in this market. You cannot remain still. So I don't think it's defensive. I think it's offensive because, as I said, you just have to become more global. You have to find new sources of growth. And, you know, in many cases, you know, the economy is very strong. There's good, solid, standalone growth. But you've got to support that with deliberate quality sources of external growth.
So U.S. companies are buying others. Is it mainly cross-border or is it amongst themselves?
A combination of both, but there's obviously there's been a lot of activity within within North America. And as I said, that's something that for the rest of the companies outside of North America, I think it is a wake-up call.
Okay, so what does Europe, we talk about European banking consolidation, but the regulatory appetite is not there. We talk about a number of European companies that should be merging. But what needs to happen for, I guess, chief executive to have the stomach to buy another big company?
I think, Francine, there's been in my judgment, there's been a change, particularly in this fourth quarter, because I think that so much of M&A is correlated to confidence, to certainty, and in the European arena, there's been a lot of sources of uncertainty. And I think it's been easy for CEOs to hold back, to see what happens. But I think that this onslaught of activity, particularly in North America, has just prompted CEOs to say, guess what? We just have to get on with it. And just in this recent vintage of deals, whether it's obviously Fiat Chrysler with PSA, LVMH with Tiffany, Novartis doing medicines companies, we've just seen European companies that I think the dam has broken, or I'd like to think it has, and they've got to say, guess what? Yes, there is uncertainty, but we just got to get on with it.